I'm Sir Tap-Tap, and welcome to Let's Play Leva Oma by Florian Veltman. An early review copy of this game was provided by the developer. First, this game's a little weird. It's listed in euros as €3 and 77 euro cents. I've never seen an uneven price for, like, it was set in euros, like, not USD, so I don't know why it was a weird price. But oops, didn't mean to skip that quite that fast. So, this is a game about the creator's grandmother, and it's a top-down mushroom collecty thing. Oop, did I skip a dialogue line? Or did he just actually say nothing? Oh, I think that's a bug. The text box for my character gets big when I press A. This is a preview build. There's going to be some, they said there'll be some accessibility options added. I'm not sure what exactly, maybe colorblind controls or something, but, this is just a chill little game. I didn't spoil myself too much on it, but just a chill little game about collecting some mushrooms with your grandma. It's going to release on April 5th, if this video is not already on the April 5th, which is grandmother's birthday, that's pretty sweet. I needed a nice, calm game like this. Oh, this has full gamepad support, apparently, by the way. It's not super uncommon in Unity, but it's always appreciated. I'm using a controller right now. It's more relaxing for me to use a controller, even if, you know, a game is pretty simple. Yeah, I needed a nice, relaxing game here. Oh, mushroom. How do I get... There we go. I do kind of wish the text was, hey. Oh. Right, species. Let's check this on before you eat them. Alrighty. Oh! Camera controls. I guess that shouldn't be a surprise. Perspective seemed forced. Oh yeah, I kind of would prefer an instant text option. I want that in, like, all games, because, you know. I do like fancy text effects. There's an upcoming game that has some really great text effects. Burrito Galaxy 65. It's not made up, but, do I have to press A? Yes. It's got some really cool texty stuff, you know, like rainbow letters, text jumping up and down and stuff. That I'm fine with, like, walkie text, you know, slow text. I guess it kind of fits this game in particular, but just in general, instant text is real nice. Really like this art style. And the shader for the, you know, seeing them through the trees, that's really nice. How can you not be relaxed playing this? I don't think it's possible. Oops, I'll try to leave the text a little longer than I can read them, because I know I read a little bit faster. I kind of wish, this is the sort of thing that I wish Steam tags were better for. Like, sometimes I just want a relaxing game. I'm getting a mushroom, Grandma. Don't go off screen, Grandma. You're not even gonna slow down? What was I saying? Yeah, sometimes I just want a nice, chill game, and it's a little hard to find sometimes. The itch.io, for now, this game is just on itch.io, I think. It's a great place to get cool games, by the way. Like, in my opinion, itch.io should be the first, you know, release point for pretty much every, you know, indie sort of thing. It's free. You can host free games of, like, large file size and stuff. So, like, there's no point in releasing crap on Dropbox and stuff anymore. Something wrong with this one? Separate bag. I don't want to get too into this issue, but there's a post on my blog about that dragon cancer, and there's about a bunch of negative stuff going on around about that, and about Let's Plays. My opinions are on that blog on that topic, but I really do like the idea of games that are like just exploring, you know, normal human experiences like this. Obviously, a bit different thematically than that dragon cancer, but a bun. But yeah, there's a lot of very human things that we don't really explore in games, and that's, well, not in big games anyway. And that's why I love weird little games like this. And this, and Emily is Away, that's a free game that, it's also on Steam, but it's just, it explores, you know, the whole experience of being a teenager using AOL Instant Messenger. What's, why can't I go that way, Grandma? A little stuck. That's a little strange. Not sure what happened there. Like I said a little earlier, this is a preview build, so might be some issues that aren't in the... It is content complete, they said. Just, you know, bug fixes, some more options for accessibility. But content-wise, we should be good. I know there's at least one more season from the store page, so I'll want to at least stick around till that. I'm not sure how long I'll play. I'm not sure how long the game is. Oh, neat. One of my favorite things in games is unusual depictions of water. What you hmmin' about, Grandma? Back. Who's back? Come on, Grandma. Speaking of grandmas, it's day before Easter over here. I actually go and see my grandma and grandpa for a little Easter dinner. Yeah, it has been a while. You're too slow. Sorry. I just really love the aesthetics of this game. Give me more weird games. This is what I want to see in VR. I don't want, you know, frickin' Super McReal gun shoot dude, gun shoots, alien guns. I want visiting, you know, getting mushrooms in the fall with grandma. This. I want this. How can you not relax? Things are getting real now. Even the music knows things are getting real. Oops. Get the mushroom. Get the mushroom. Oh, terrible. Oh. I have my own story sort of like that. I actually graduated high school a year early. So, I was always a year younger than everyone else through all of college. Just a little weird. The weirdest thing was I was 21 for exactly less than a month. I turned 21 the week before finals. So I couldn't, you know, drink it all. And like, well, I could have if I wanted to be a complete idiot, but I didn't. I couldn't, you know, do the whole legal college drinking thing. I was sort of considering taking an extra year, but by halfway through that fourth year, I decided, nah, that's too dumb. No, why would I do that? I just love reflections. It sort of adds that the game is about reflection. There's something a little weird going on with the shaders there, though, with the trees oscillating in the reflection, but not a big deal. I like the stride difference. You can see, you can tell the difference between Grandma's steps than mine. Oh, here we go. Oh. I'm an adult now. I don't know if this game has, you know, emotions, but I went in blind, but there seems to be some potential for that. You know what I mean. This is kind of like what I wish I felt while playing Proteus. I enjoyed Proteus. Hey, it's the Blue Heron, right? What are you still doing here? You were supposed to go for the winner. Hey, buddy. What's going on? What was I saying? But yeah, Proteus, I can't help but get frustrated with the low walk speed in that. For some reason, it's different. It's different in this one, because, you know, I'm... Oh, phone. I thought that was my real phone, but... Oh, the text is a little small, so I guess a little late to mention this, but you'll probably want to watch in 1080p. I'm not really one of the read all of the dialogue people. I've considered it, but I don't know. Wait, that was a call, not a... I was about to say my grandma definitely doesn't text me, but I guess a phone call is a bit different. Oh, wait, we're back as a kid again, I guess. Whenever a game like this goes to winter, I get a little antsy. Winter is a very symbolic thing. What an ideal stopping point for this video will be. Well, we'll see if we get one more season change and we'll poke around a bit. We're not quite at 15 minutes, which is my usual... Well, honestly, 30 minutes, unless the game ends earlier, is more often what I end up at. We'll take a bit more of a peek. Got some evergreens mixed in here. We got firewood! Got 7 mushrooms. Yeah, they actually keep trees a bit more sparse to prevent forest fires. My sister lives in California and has to deal with forest... Well, not like deal with, but there's forest fires and sometimes roads get blocked and stuff, and that's scary stuff. Come on, Grandma. I don't really know what to say. This is the calmest I've been in a long time. This is just quite enjoyable and relaxing. Oh, you can run! Huh. Whee! I didn't even think to press all the buttons, really. It's pretty much just that. I'm not sure if Grandma even... I don't think she'll run to keep up, so it doesn't really matter too much. But if you want to run... So you've got some nice different environments here. Oop. What was that? It's like, nope, the camera's confused. Even though I know that thing is just a text box bug, it looks so much like me accidentally skipping a text box. Which is like my greatest fear in a dialogue-driven game. I'm usually a fan of big, all-at-once dialogue, like, you know, a nice big text box with, like a whole paragraph, but, this writing really works well, line by line. So I tend to strongly dislike walking slowly in, you know, in walking sim stuff, but in this game it feels, you know, purposeful, and you know, I'm just walking with Grandma. It feels right in this game. It usually doesn't. Like, in Everybody's Gone to the Rapture, I just didn't really feel a need to be going as slow as you do. I don't really feel impeded in this game, though. Even though I can go a little bit faster. I guess there's no point in not going faster in the adult segment. That's kind of funny. As a kid, you run, you know, like a kid would, but you just sort of go at a faster gait as an adult. That's a really cool touch. This is the sort of game that I want to see more of. This is the sort of, you know, just a really cool experience that, you know. People might say it's less like a, you know, it's not very much like a game, but I mean, it's not the same if it's not interactive. This isn't something you could, well, you could do something very similar, you know, in a short story or, you know, a video short or something, but it's not the same as, you know, I'm here now. This is me, and I'm with my grandma, and it's not the same if I'm just reading about somebody else's grandma. Now I'm glad I found the run button. Alright, we'll find the lake. I think the lake will be a good stopping point. I have no idea how long this is. I'm not the type to complain about length, though, and I mean, it's under 4 euros. That's, I mean, if you want to just get it, don't. I'm not gonna fuss over hours per dollar at that low. Like, little boat, rest in peace, boat. A lot of people that don't, you know, get snow where they live, they think snow is great. Or like, they, you know, it's really exotic and stuff. I mean, it's nice to see, but it's not as great as you might think. It's neat once, and then, you know, you have to deal with it for 3 months, and it's a pain in the butt. And it doesn't stay pretty. It looks that way in movies and stuff, but after one day, it's all, you know, brown and stuff. Oh, you can't bump Grandma. It looked like I could. Music's a nice touch. It's very just calming and atmospheric. Sorry, I just love being able to move the camera. For some reason, it just feels right. We haven't actually collected particularly many mushrooms. That's fine. I always thought it was weird people just find, you know, forage for random mushrooms and trust them and stuff. But I mean, I guess if you know what you're doing, it's probably not too bad. We got fog! There's only one, restaurant where I like mushrooms. It closed down a couple years ago. It's this Chinese and Cantonese place, and they would make this, vegetable beef stuff, and I would always get it real spicy, and they cooked the mushrooms just right, and they had, I always hate the texture of mushrooms, and just, it's the sauce, I think. They just tasted right, and they were just the right texture to not be awful, I guess. I've never found another place that I actually like the mushrooms at. And they were, they left them pretty thick. Like, they weren't thin sliced ones. They were, they'd be like half the mushroom there. But I don't know, something about, I think it's the sauce that was just made everything magical, because there's real spicy stuff, at least if you ask for it. And I was pretty sad when they closed that place down. The, I guess the owner retired for, health reasons. What are we doing in the lake house here? Oh, bird watching cabin, I see. Superb omelet. I should try to make omelet sometime. I'm lazy, so I usually make scrambled eggs at most. If I wake up in time for breakfast, which I usually don't, probably my biggest complaint about my current job is that I wake up, you know, I have to be there at 8, and, ugh. I honestly think my quality of life would be pretty, a lot higher if I could just sleep until, you know, 9 or so. Get up, start working at maybe 10, 11. Like, I don't even feel very productive in the morning anyway. Speaking of quality of life, what happened to that Nintendo thing? I'm not entirely convinced that was ever a real thing, honestly. Also, I love the all caps, because you know your grandma talks way too loud over the phone. Everyone's does. It's just a grandma thing. Like, my grandpa, who can barely hear, he doesn't talk too loud over the phone, but my grandma does. If you hear weird scraping, I fiddle way too much with my Xbox Elite controller, which is exactly the right controller to play a game like this with. Ah, I guess that's the end. Game by Florian Veltman. Music by Timothy Gougley? Sorry, I completely forgot to mention. Viva Oma is Dutch for Dear Grandmother. I recognize it because it's extremely close to Liebe Oma, from which is German, Dutch and German, extremely close. You know how you can sort of tell what stuff in French and Spanish mean by knowing English? Dutch and German are kind of like that. It's a lot. It's a very close language. So yeah, that is Liebe Oma. I didn't quite mean to play the whole thing in one sitting, but I mean, I guess it's about that length. Yeah, that, if you ever want to just chill. Oh, it's the starting thing. Oh, I didn't even notice that. So the end is where you start. That's neat. Yeah, this is Liebe Oma. It is on itch.io. It's only 4 euros, slightly less than 4 euros. I think itch.io, you know, handles the currency conversion stuff. I know PayPal does anyway. Yeah, this is Liebe Oma, and I thoroughly enjoy that.